proportion in European societies, because Christians were not permitted to marry twice or more than two times, the whole society was imbalanced. There was a much larger number of women in the society than men. So those extra women, what were they doing? They were corrupting the society, corrupting the husbands of those who were married. So practically, they were living with so many wives, in fact. Only this time it was not legalized. So the issue is whether you should have legalized wives or illegal wives. Of course, legalized wives is a much better and saner answer, isn't it? Right? So I hope you don't wish to be born after the war. I hope you don't wish that you grow up at a time when there is an after the war period, when you can marry more than once. You understand my question? What do I say?
Pardon?
What have I said?
You said that you wouldn't like to grow up.
I wish that you are not nursing a wish in your heart, that you grow up at a time, you become marriageable at a time when a war is just over and there is a surplus of women, where men can marry more than twice. Now you understand what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And is that what you wish? What is your personal desire? Tell me. Why did you think at all of such a question at your age? That is what is bothering me. I'm wondering why. Because you told me in answer to my question that there was no person to your knowledge in your entire large family who had married twice. Correct?
Yeah.
And the present period of peace is where we find the women to be almost in the equal number as that of men. Correct?
Yeah.
So why did this question occur to you? And you are so young, you are not yet adult, are you?
Hmm.
Why this question occurred to you? That is what I am wondering. Can you answer?
No.
No? No. Why I am saying it is because I wanted to understand. My comment was just by way of joke. Don't take them seriously. What I was wondering was, do you confront such questions at schools from your Christian friends?
Yeah.
So why didn't you tell me that? You should have told me this idea didn't occur to you, but it was because Christian friends in school ask you this question very often. Correct?
Yeah.
So now can you answer them properly? Are you well equipped with this answer? Do you remember it clearly? So that whenever you are faced with such a question, you can respond to your own and to their satisfaction? Right?
Yeah.
Good. You see, once I remember, I thought of this because when I was a student of the University of London in 1956, long before you were ever, I think your father was born, of course, at that period, but not you, huh? Certainly not. Huh?
Yeah.
So at that time, when there was no family of yours to have given birth to you,
yeah,
when I was a student at the University of London, we, the Muslim students, were generally confronted with this question. And sometimes some non-Muslims tried to tease some Muslim boys by way of mocking at them, joking with them. And once I remember, a Muslim boy at the university was suddenly confronted with this question. Somebody who was in a nasty mood, he said, "Look here, I understand you have four mothers." So the immediate response was, "And I understand you have four fathers." You know, it was a pun on the word four fathers. But a very quick response and a good repartee. What he meant was that here, you live in a promiscuous society where you don't care, free mixing with each other. So if I say you have four fathers, it is not just an allegation, it may happen. So this answer was by way of a response to a nasty question, but there is wisdom in it. The hard fact is that in those societies where they do not permit man to marry twice, more than once I mean, when such situations appear where extra number of women are left, then there is a free mixing on both sides, then permissiveness develops, and then it's not just a question of man having four wives, then it also becomes a question of polyandry, where women don't hesitate to have extramarital relations. So the whole society is corrupted. So this is another aspect to which I wanted to your attention to be drawn. If such debate grows further, you can point out at this evil as well. Right? Thank you.
Assalamu alaikum.
Assalamu alaikum.
This is not unacceptable. Last week, watching on the TV, you should pay my.
What is he reading? What is he reading to himself?
So he's saying his family is accepted.
When? Pardon?
His family is accepted last week.
Yes. When? When?
About a few weeks, about last week.
About last week.
Last week? Mm-hmm. And has he also accepted Ahmadiyya?
Yes.
Along with the family or not?
Yes.
Yes. And which family do you belong to? Could you introduce your family background, please?
Birmingham.
No. Birmingham is not your family background, is it? Do you hear from Hindu, Muslims,
Muslim.
Christians or what?
Muslim.
Muslims. From India? Originally? From Bangladesh?
Yeah.
From Bangladesh. Are you coming from East London or Birmingham, right?
Birmingham.
Right. So when did your, last week your family became Ahmadi Muslims?
Yes.
All together, right? Okay. Now what is your question, please?
In what in your opinion should be my priority to become a good Ahmadi Muslim?
What in your opinion should be my priority to become a good?
Yes. You see, the priority of every Muslim is the same as the priority of every Ahmadi, because we are Muslims. So you should understand fully that you have not changed your religion. You have changed your understanding of that religion with the purpose that you become a better Muslim. So the priority in Ahmadiyyat is to practice Islam as you believe in it. You understand?
Yes.
If previously you did not say your prayers four times properly, if you did not pay attention to the recitation of the Quran, if you had no desire to understand the message of God to you, that is the Quran, then after becoming an Ahmadi, you should now pay serious attention to these lapses in your training. You understand?
Yes.
So, keep in touch with the Murabbis, that is the Ahmadi missionaries there, or Khudamul Ahmadiyya office bearers, etc., and other elders of the Jamaat, and try first of all to improve your knowledge of Islam. If you have not learned the meaning of the prayer which you recite during every prayer in every day, then you should learn, you should begin your learning program from that. It is extremely important for every Ahmadi child and youth to understand what he is saying to God. When you appear in the prayer five times a day, every rakat you say something. What that something is, if you don't understand, then your appearance in the prayer before God is just a formality.